Today, we will analyze the data of human resources through Power BI. We will analyze the data of active and departed employees. We will look into the future requirements of human resources. We will examine how many employees are required to be hired on urgent basis, or in near future. We will review the human resource practices by analyzing the average hiring quality and employees score. The human resource hiring quality is being determined on the basis of employees' score and their retention rate. A Google spreadsheet will be used as a data source for our Power BI dashboard. This spreadsheet contains all the information required to perform the human resource analysis. Import the data from this spreadsheet into the Power BI using the Get Data feature. Select the Google Sheet as source data. Press Connect and enter the link to the Google Sheet into the dialog box. Press OK and wait for the Power BI to load data into the navigator. Now select the sheet you want to import and press Transform Data. This will display the Power Query Editor, where you can perform editing and data modeling on the source data. Click on, use the first row as headers. Filter out any unnecessary information from the data. When you are done, press Close and Apply to load the data into the Power BI. When data is loaded, all the fields are displayed on the right side of the interface. Add a text box at the top of the dashboard to create a title for your dashboard. Type the title, change the font size and place the title at the top of the dashboard. Add a visual border to the title text box. Drag the status field to the dashboard area. Change the visual to a slicer. Place the slicer at the top right corner of the dashboard. For our next visual, we will add any non-numeric field to the dashboard. Then we will change the visual to a card. Change the field setting to count. Change the title of the field to employees. This will allow us to display the number of employees. Make sure that this field has no empty values. Add visual borders to the slicer. Visual borders improve the appearance of dashboard. Add a gauge chart to the dashboard. Add the score field to the value area and change it to average. Add the score field to the minimum value area and change it to minimum. Change its title to low. Add the score field to maximum value area, change it to maximum, and rename it to high. You can also add the score field to the target value area as maximum. Add a visual border to the gauge chart. Make a copy of the gauge chart, and place it below the existing gauge chart. Replace all the score fields with the hiring quality field. Show the average hiring quality as current value. Show the minimum hiring quality as the minimum value. Show the maximum hiring quality as the maximum value. You can also show the maximum hiring quality as the target value. Now you can analyze the quality of hiring in the organization using candidate score and the hiring quality score. Since the maximum value and the target value are the same, you can remove the target value fields. Add a map chart to the dashboard. Add the office field as location. Add the count of designation field as number of employees, in the bubble size area. Change the map style to light, from the map settings. Add a visual border to the map chart. Rename the count of designation to employees. Add the age field to the dashboard to analyze the employees by their ages. Add the age field to the x-axis and the designation field to the y-axis. Rename the count of designation to employees. As you can see, most of the employees are young, between the age of 20 and 30. Add a visual border to the bar chart. Add a pie or a donut chart to the dashboard. Add the hiring quality field to the pie chart to analyze the hiring quality of the organization. Add the designation field to the values area of the pie chart, as number of employees. Add a visual barter to the pie chart. Create a copy of the pie chart, and place it at the bottom left corner of the dashboard. Replace the hiring quality field with the required field, to analyze the future human resource requirement of the organization. This chart will show you how many people you need to hire immediately, urgently, or in the near future. The human resource requirement is calculated from the date of retirement of existing employees. Make a copy of the employee's requirement chart, and place it right next to the existing chart. Replace the required field with the hiring field, to analyze the employees by their hiring. This chart shows us how many employees were freshly hired, and number of remaining employees. Add a stacked bar chart to the dashboard. Add the designation field to the stacked bar chart, as number of employees. Add the same designation field to the y-axis as well. This chart will show us the number of employees by their designation. Turn on the visual borders for the stack bar chart. Make a copy of the bar chart, and place it at the bottom right corner of the dashboard. Replace the y-axis designation field with the exit cause field to analyze the number of employees by the reason of their exit. This field will show us why employees are leaving the organization. But it will only work if the departed is selected from the status slicer. Our human resource analysis dashboard is now complete. It shows us the employees by their location, age, and hiring quality. It also shows us how many employees are required to be hired in the future, and why employees are leaving our organization. We can analyze and improve the hiring quality of the human resource using this dashboard. Please feel free to ask any question, or leave a feedback in the comments section. Thanks for watching and liking our tutorials.